Okay, coming to the next problem, here the same type of problem here. The first one is the ratio is 3 is to 2. Now the ratio is have taken as 5 is to 3. So same construction part what we have, that only we have to go through it and nothing else. So how to do this? First step, what is the first step? We have to add this ratio, that is 5 is to 3. That time we have added 3 plus 2. Here now we have to add this 5 plus 3. 5 plus 3 is how much? 8. So write down any one side, that is 8, you have the total ratio. The total ratio of the line is 8, and here they have not mentioned how much centimeter. That is also most important, how much centimeter they have not mentioned. So you can take your own how much centimeter you want, that much you can take. And 5 is to 3 it is, just how to understand. So let me keep this later, this one we will check it later. So we will go for this. So first step is what? We have to take one line segment, how much you want, that much centimeter, because they have not mentioned. Again and again I'm saying the same thing. So you take down 1 centimeter, how much you want, that is, it is left to you. So I will take little bit more only this time, because the lengths are very big, no? So I will take little bit more. This much I have taken. I also don't know how much centimeters, nearly 15 centimeter, or you can make it 16 if you want, because A2s are 16, yes. So it will get to 2 ratio also. If you want, make it 16, otherwise keep it 15 only, no problem. Okay, that is, we will not bother about that. So A, we will keep it this one, and other side we will take it as B. This is most important, the A and comma B, that we have to write it down. So next step is, we have to do, we have already added that 5 plus 3, that is the ratios, 5 plus 3 is equals to 8, that we have added already. Now very importantly, we have to draw an acute angle at A. The second step is to draw the acute angle. Acute angle it is, not anything other. So you can draw how much you want, it is left to you. Means big also you can draw, or small also you can draw. The centimeter is not needed. So this one you can take as x. So a x we can take. Now most important, that time in the previous question we have done the 5 parts over here, because it was a 3 is to 2 ratio. But now it is not 3 is to 2 ratio, it is 5 is to 3. So totally 8 parts we have to do. So now again take a compass, your own measurement. I am not telling that you have to take same measurement, 1 centimeter only. You can take any measurement, but you have to use the compass only, not to use your scale to measure, because in exam they will ask your, they will see whether you are doing with the scale or whether you are doing with the compass. So you have to use the compass only and make it any 1 centimeter, means how much centimeter you want you can take. And here you have to keep on A, see exactly at A how to keep, okay, how much centimeter, where you have joined, there only you have to keep, and draw 8 lines. You have to draw 8 lines. So 1, keep on this point now, and next 2, small line, don't want big, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and here is the 8th. Okay, 8 parts you have done. After doing this 8 parts, you have to name them. So I will write down the name. The first one is A1. This first point what we have, A1. Second point we have taken A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, and last one is A8. Here most importantly, see here all of you, one thing, the first ratio is very important role, it plays very important role, and the last, that is not 3, the total value 8 will play a very important role. Means here now we have to use this A8 as a point, and we need that first ratio, that is 5, that is here A5. These two ratios are very important for us, okay, because see, you see from A to A1 one ratio, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this A5 you are going to get one line. Okay, the first ratio. Next, A5 to 1, 6 is 1, 2 and 3. So this is 5 ratio and this one is 3 ratio. And so here we are making the ratio. So same thing we will do. So from now, that last point, that 8th ratio, that is what you have. 8 to B, we have to join. This is a very important. Just when you are joining, make your pencil sharpen, because if you have thick line you are going to get the wrong answer. So for that purpose, so now the one step is over. The next step is, again you have to take a compass and you have to keep now on A8. That time we kept on A5 that time, so now you have to keep on A8 because last line, and adjust yourself how much you want, you can adjust. I'm not saying the different thing you have to do, but no, don't change once again. So keep on 8 and draw one arc. Okay, the same, again no need to change this, same mark, you have to keep on A5. Why have to keep on A5? Because ratio is 5. So A5 you have to keep same at A5 exactly, and draw one more arc on the A5. Like this, a little bit big if you draw, no problem, no problem. So A5 you have drawn. Okay, so now next is very important. Now you can change it. After changing, change it, and now see that we have kept on A8 and you have drawn one arc that is touching this here and this point AB, A8B. Yes, this is most important. So how much it is, just to measure, same measurement you have to keep on this point A4. This is not A4, that is A5. From there you have drawn one arc, so it is touching somewhere here. So this point, not A4 actually, and you have to cut the previous arc. It is touching at a point. That point is required now. And now this point, what you have got, and this A5 point, we have to join. And you have to draw little bit in big line. So one thing you remember, when you will join these lines, this line must be, what you have got, a new line, that is C, I will take this A5 to C. What you have got from the A5 to C, that line must be parallel to this A8 to B. Okay, means it doesn't not meet. So you can see it is parallel now. Not touching each other means if it is not nearby and all. So now you can write it on at the end. So here you can write it on that A8B, and ratio we have A5C. Okay, we write down the parallel line first. Both of them are parallel. Ratio also we can write it down now. So this A8B and A5C in a means parallel line. So this ratio will be AC. The ratio, this CB will be in the ratio 5:3. If you are not getting it, just we can go with the calculation part. So now you can see A to A5, what measurement we have, A to A5 measurement what we have, divided by A5 to A8, what is the measurement we have, that is equals to A to C, ratio I am talking, and that is equals to CB or BC, what we can say. So now you can count A to A5, how much measurement, how much ratio we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 ratio we have. So A to A5 is the ratio is 5. In down we have A5 to A8. The ratios you can see 1, 2 and 3. So it ratio is 3. A5 to A8 is the ratio is 1, 2, 3. That is equals to AC to CB. This is only they have told you to find now. 5:3. So here we have AC is 5, and CB is 3. This is our justification. This is our justification. So in exam, they will ask the 2 marks question to draw the ratio, inner ratio, and also they will ask you to write down the justification. Justification is this much only, that is nothing but A to A5 divided by A5 to A8. Okay, A to A5 divided by A5 to A8. That is equals to, we can see the same ratio we have taken parallel, and we have, so this, how much angle, same angle we have taken. So AC and CB will be equal. So A to A5 divided by A5 to A8 is equals to AC by CB. A to A5 value, just now we know that 5 difference we have, so 5 we have taken. A5 to A8 we have 3 difference, so we have taken here 3. Next, that is equals to AC by CB, I have written as it is, only have changed this one. Now you can understand, so AC by CB, AC and CB are in a ratio 5:3. That is our final answer. I hope you understood this. If you understood this, very good. So those who have a doubt, you can write it in a comment section and you can ask me. Okay, thank you for watching this PSM. So like, subscribe and share my channel. See you in my next video. Till then, take care.